In this session, we're going to look at bit fields. A bit field is something that allows us to store multiple bits together. So we can use one byte or one word, one integer, one character, to store information about individual bits. So a good example would be looking at the condition code register or status register of a processor. So we have here we have six individual bits that each represent something different, but it doesn't make sense to use six integers or six characters to represent those when we can store them all together. Sometimes we also have things that are associated. So we have three bits that represent a value, we have another two bits that represent something else, and another four that represent something. Again, we could take up three separate variables, but we could store them all in one. So what happens with a bit field is that now these bits are treated as a set of bits. We can access them individually, or we can access them as a whole. When we're defining bit fields, we're going to set them up exactly the same way we would a structure. So we're going to use the structure keyword, we're going to give it a name, we're going to have the different data types inside our structures, each with its own field name. The thing that's different is this last part where we have a colon, and the colon indicates we're now going to specify the number of bits. So this is going to be the number of bits that we need for that particular field. So here we've said the first one needs size 1, the second one needs size 2. The third one isn't saying we want a size of 0, but it's saying maybe these were integer values, and that's saying take me to the beginning of the next integer. So I want these two stored in 1, and I want this stored separately. And this one would take size 3. Then, once we've defined our template, we're actually going to use that data type to define a variable that holds our bit fields. So let's take a look at how we could set up a bit field to hold the information for a condition code register or a status register. So here's the bit patterns that we need, and here's the structure, and I'm going to call that template name CCR register, and inside I'm going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fields that represent each of the 6 bits. I'm going to use an unsigned integer for each, and I'm going to say H requires 1 bit, I requires 1 bit, N, Z, V, and C each require 1 bit. So in total, I'm using 6 bits, even though it looks like I'm using 6 unsigned integers. I'm actually only using 1, and I'm using 6 individual bits inside. Now here, I have defined my data type, and my variable name is going to be CCR. The field names are right here. Now if I wanted to assign multiple bits to a bit field, so here for example I want 3 bits grouped together. I want 2 bits grouped, and then I want 4 bits grouped. What I can do is say for options I want 3 bits. So this would be options. Then for track I want 2 bits. So this one would be track. Then I want a done flag. So I have 1 bit here. So this would be done. Then I have my force it to the next field, to the next unsigned integer. And there I'm going to have value. So we're actually going to have a break. So this is going to be stored in one unsigned integer. This will be stored in another. So this one would be value. My data type is struct small associated data, and my variable name is info. So now let's take a look at what we can do. So let's say we want to be able to set a bit field. So for some reason we want to set the overflow bit in the condition code register. So our variable name was CCR. We use the field operator, which is a dot, and then the name of the bit field. And here, we can say that field is 1. So that was a 1 bit field. If for some reason we assigned a larger value, it's going to truncate. So if we said assign 2, that bit would actually get set to 0 because 2 in binary is 1, 0. So it's going to pick up this bit from that value. For our other bit field that we set up, we had track. So we have the name of the variable, the field with the dot operator, and we're assigning the value 3 to that. So it's just like assigning any field in any structure. Just keep in mind that your size is limited by the size of the field, and it will truncate. Now, getting information into a bit field is a little bit trickier because we can't read directly into that field. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to read it into a variable and then assign that variable to the field inside the bit field. If we want to test a bit field, so we could say if ccr.z, and remember that it is looking for a true test, then we're going to print the result of the last operation was 0. So if ccr.z is set, in other words it's non-zero, it's going to print the result of the last operation was 0.